it's the final show before WCW New Blood Rising. Welcome to WCW Monday Nitro, live from Hershey, Pennsylvania. Started off in a big way. The man Goldberg versus Roman Reigns to start off the night here on Nitro.
Oh, play! It's gonna be a big show tonight, man, but it's gonna be even bigger at New Blood Rising. I cannot wait to see what Shane McMahon's gonna say later tonight regarding New Blood Rising.
And ladies and gentlemen, what a trouble night we're going to have here on WCW Monday Nitro. There's also been rumors that Sting will be here tonight. Shane McMahon is putting together the WCW New Blood Rising card already. We don't even have a main event yet. That's what we want to find out here tonight. Is it going to be Ethan Carter III versus Samoa Joe? Or will it be Okada versus Samoa Joe? Will we see Billy Gunn versus Ethan Carter III? Ethan Carter III is supposed to contractually debut at WCW New Blood Rising. So he will not be able to debut before then. He will not be able to compete here tonight. However, looking at the card, what's confirmed here tonight so far is Billy Gunn and Okada. We will speak to Ethan Carter III possibly. But he hasn't arrived to the arena just yet.
Hey man, card subject to change.
Roman Reigns has not been very successful here in WCW since he turned his back on The Rock. The Rock defeating him at WCW Starrcade. The Rock was trying to steer Roman Reigns in the right direction. It did not work. And Roman Reigns instead has found his own personality once again. But is it the right personality? Personally, I like the Roman Reigns of old.
Hey, Roman Reigns, he ain't doing too bad. I mean, he did headline a pay-per-view against Samoa Joe. So he ain't doing that bad. He beat The Undertaker with a headbutt. He didn't even have to fist him in the face. He didn't need to hit him with that spear. He simply headbutted him.
Yeah, but that was when he had that protective mask on his face. When he had that busted up nose at the hands of the Disciple. Having a loss to the Disciple? That's gotta be hard on Roman Reigns. No disrespect to the Disciple.
Yo, man, listen. Alright, yeah, he hit that stunner or whatever he calls that move, the apocalypse. He hit it on Roman Reigns. He busted up his face with it. It's all good, though, because now Roman Reigns is 100%. His face is all right. He's about to take care of business right now. He's about to take out Goldberg.
And Goldberg steps up to Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns, he rolls out of the ring. He's not ready just yet to go up against Goldberg, which has knocked over JBL's hat here. Roman Reigns is out of there again. at the intensity from Goldberg right now.
Hey, man, Goldberg can keep this up all he wants, man. I like to see this. He can knock himself out. Roman Reigns will be able to get the pin and beat him as easy as that.
Serve up! He's scared!
He's not scared, man. He probably got a cell phone or something backstage. You need to get real quick. The ref need to give him a break real quick, alright? I'm just saying. He going back to the ring. He remembered he got it. Don't worry about it.
Here we go. Goldberg and Roman Reigns. They lock up. Roman Reigns showing his power. Pushing him over to the ropes here. Oh, and a right hand. Not going to be a clean break there, and then he walks out of the ring.
Yeah, but he's got the upper hand right now, man. He's got the advantage, and that's all that matters right now, man. Roman Reigns is playing mind games with Goldberg. Goldberg, he's always playing mind games with everyone else. Pretend that he's this cyborg, man. It ain't working tonight.
Oh, an elbow over the back of the neck by Goldberg. Goes for a right hand, but Roman Reigns answers back with a right hand of his own. God, look at these thick right hands from Roman Reigns, and Goldberg doesn't seem to be too affected by that. Back spin kick on Roman Reigns has him teetering on the ropes. Speaking of teetering on the ropes, Goldberg just throwing him on top rope right here. He affects those ribs, that spear, it's going to end Roman Reigns. Both these guys known for using that spear. Goldberg, I think the very first person to actually start using a spear. He definitely did make it famous. It's ended a few matches here and there, but he likes to pick him back up, hit him with that jackhammer. The spear, it should be enough to already end the match. But he's still not done at that point. He wants to make sure it's all over when he hits that jackhammer. And now look at this, Roman Reigns. He's doing a good job right now though, Serva.
Of course he is, man. That's the big dog, Roman Reigns. He may have been defeated once by Goldberg, but that was a fluke victory. Goldberg got lucky. Tonight, Roman Reigns is going to put Goldberg down in his return to Monday Night's Raw. Watch this, man. You see that? Roman Reigns making sure he use up that energy that he got. So he don't... Oh, come on, man. When's the last time Goldberg ever did a DDT? Why all of a sudden he wanted to decide to do a DDT all of a sudden?
It was a little effective. Goldberg not known for using DDTs, but he used it here tonight. Not one of his strongest moves in his arsenal. Roman Reigns, oh, he tries to step up to Goldberg. Goldberg kicks him right in his gut. But Roman Reigns takes advantage, the backbreaker affecting the back right now, the spine of Goldberg. And he elbows him right in the ribs. And when you get slammed on your back, it also affects the ribs. It really shakes the liver. And right now, Goldberg. Oh, the shoulders to the ribs are going to do a lot of damage. Gotta be careful. Roman Reigns is open for the spear by Goldberg.
Gotta be kidding me, man. Roman's gotta get up.
That's it, Serva. It is all over.
It's not over yet, man. Goldberg ain't going for cover. Oh, come on. Oh, no.
Wait a minute.
Oh.
Not
play. Oh, not, come on.
Not going for the jackhammer afterwards like he usually does. Changing up the game plan here. They'll put one more move in before he jackhammers Roman Reigns. Oh my God, Roman Reigns with the counter on Goldberg, setting up for a spear of his own. Might be too close though, man. Not got enough momentum there.
I think he got enough momentum there. It doesn't matter if Goldberg was that close, man. He speared the hell out of him.
Goldberg.
That's it.
He kicked out.
You gotta be kidding me.
Goldberg got that shoulder up before the three. Oh, and Roman Reigns stomping on the arm of Goldberg. Gonna try to go for a pinfall one more time.
That'll be a three this time.
But he gets his foot on the rope. Wait a minute, he got his foot on the rope.
Roman Reigns just beat Goldberg.
He got his foot on the rope.
What the hell? Again, he ain't seen anything. I don't know what you're talking about, player. I ain't see a damn thing. Roman Reigns just beat Goldberg. The referee never saw his foot on the ropes. It's all over, man. Even if he got his foot on the ropes, it was probably way too late anyway. Congratulations to Roman Reigns. Look at that spear, man. That spear laid Goldberg out. Oh, player. Look at that. Look at this, man. Two. And he kicked out. It was all good, but once he stomped on his arm right there, that weak arm they injured years ago, it was all over, man. Career-threatening right there, man. What a beautiful stomp from Roman Reigns.
Look at this. His foot's on the ropes right before the three count.
It's a shame the referee didn't see that foot on the ropes, man. All right, I agree. He got foot on the ropes, but the referee never saw it, so it doesn't matter, man.
Roman Reigns
ain't done yet, player.
Roman.
Look at Goldberg.
You won the match.
He don't know where he is.
Come on.
Superman punch.
What a bunch of BS. Roman Reigns, so disrespectful. Now, well, later on tonight, we will see Okada versus Billy Gunn. It is confirmed here tonight. And Ethan Carr III, from what I hear, he is on his way to the building here tonight. He will be here. He has something to say. Here tonight in our main event, we will see Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows team up to take on Shinsuke Nakamura and the World Heavyweight Champion Samoa Joe, the undefeated Samoa Joe. And I think this is his first tag team match here in WCW. If there's anybody he could trust, it's definitely Shinsuke Nakamura.
Can he though? If Nakamura loses, his streak is over.
And now here we go with Team Perfection led by Paul Heyman, Ty Dillinger, and Curtis Axel.
Man, Dolph Ziggler versus Sting tonight. That's gonna be incredible to see. Is Sting even alive tonight, man? I got good word out there that he ain't gonna be here tonight, man. He was gonna be here until he found out he was taking on Dolph Ziggler. Then he realized, you know what? I'ma go home. I'ma chill. So here tonight, we'll see if Dolph Ziggler actually takes on Sting or if he's taking home a W for free.
I'm pretty sure Sting will be here to take on Dolph Ziggler here on Nitro. But tonight, in the main event, Shinsuke Nakamura and Samoa Joe, you brought up a good point. If Nakamura loses, that's the end of Samoa Joe's streak. Because technically, he's a part of a team. If both members of the team loses, no matter who gets pinned. So we'll see what happens here tonight in the main event. But right now, we got Team Perfection. Who are they going to be taking on? We don't have it listed who their opponents are here tonight. Curtis Axel and Ty Dillinger will be taking on a mystery team here tonight. Curtis Axel, the former WWE Intercontinental Champion. He almost became a WCW United States Champion against Randy Orton and John Cena. Unfortunately, it did not happen. John Cena would pin Curtis Axel in a three-way match to take the title from Randy Orton. Randy Orton never even got pinned to lose the title. Of course, John Cena and Randy Orton are tag team champions now. It's crazy how that worked out. Shinsuke Nakamura The man that got the tag team titles taken away from him and Okada is now the United States champion. And Okada could be looking at the World Heavyweight Championship after what we saw last week. We still don't know. But tonight he's taking on Billy Gunn. If he beats Billy Gunn, I'm sure he'll prove himself here tonight. If Billy Gunn beats him, though, I'm sure Billy Gunn will prove he should probably get a world title match. And even then, would it be against Okada or Samoa Joe? Okada's the IWGP World Heavyweight Champion. And here comes Mark Henry, one of the opponents for Curtis Axel and Ty Dillinger.
And now it comes down to who the tag team partner is, though. That's what I want to know. Let's see who we're going to be teaming up with here tonight, right? Could be D'Lo Brown. He teamed up with D'Lo Brown in the past.
And Mark Henry's more successful on his own, I believe. He's in team with Theodore Long and Rodney Mack at one point. That didn't last very long, though. Mark Henry, who had gone to find success even without Theodore Long managing. And now let's see what happens. Let's see who the partner is for Mark Henry here tonight. And I don't mean to make excuses for Mark Henry if he was to lose his match, but they have a good chance of winning, though. He's teaming up with Apollo Crews. And this guy is so talented. So incredible in that ring. It's going to be incredible to see Apollo Crews and Mark Henry team up. Apollo Crews also has a lot of strength on his side as well, just like Mark Henry.
Bubba and Devon, they had a loss, man. They took a loss by, and the Dudleys went on to become the WCW Tag Team Champions.
Yeah, well, you're not wrong about that. Apollo Crews and Mark Henry weren't too successful. They were very successful in the tournament. They did not win, though. Didn't get a win against Mark Henry and, I mean, Devon and Bubba. But Mark Henry and Apollo Crews, guys, have another chance here tonight on Nitro. There's the bell. Here we go. Ty Dillinger runs into a boot. Just like that, Mark Henry takes him out. And so far, I still can't believe we saw Roman Reigns defeat Goldberg here tonight. Goldberg, he has foot on the ropes, though. The referee never saw it, unfortunately. But referee's decision is final. He did not restart the match. I'm not even sure if he knew that Goldberg ever had his foot on the ropes. And then Roman Reigns attacking Goldberg after the match. Also another reason why Goldberg wouldn't have had a chance to tell him that his foot was on the ropes.
Man, shut up. Stop making excuses for Goldberg. He lost his match here tonight. Roman Reigns won. End of discussion, right? That's what's always going to say on the record books. Roman Reigns defeated Goldberg. Mark Henry trying to go for the pin. And, oh, you see that? The referee saw it, though. The referee saw the rope break that time, see? Ty Dillinger, man. Great ring awareness, knowing where the ropes were. Unfortunately for Goldberg, he should have grabbed the rope instead of putting his foot on it. That's the mistake that Goldberg made right there, man.
Yeah, well, that was then. This is now. Here tonight, we're supposed to see the return of Sting, possibly, but no guarantees. Sting has not been promoted for this show. We're only merely going on the rumors that we've heard. We don't even know what happened to Sting. We don't know if he disappeared on his own, or if he was attacked. There was a lot of rumors going on. Even the Undertaker didn't know what was going on with Sting. But while Sting was absent, Undertaker took out Sid Vicious. And Sid Vicious was taken out with an injury. From what I hear, he suffered a broken neck at the hands of the Undertaker with that tombstone on the concrete in the parking lot. Look at this, Ty Dillinger with a perfect 10 elbow drop right into the chest of Mark Henry. Is it going to be enough to put him away, though? Not going to be enough. It may have been a perfect 10, but wasn't as good as the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Hey, man, it's all good, player. Because Mark Henry's still suffering right now. He's okay, maybe not suffering. In fact, he's probably not doing bad at all right now. Yeah, Ty Dillinger, he in trouble right now. Did you ever find out Ty Dillinger has any relation to Doug Dillinger?
No, but that would make Ty Dillinger a second-generation superstar, just like Curtis Axel, if he was the son of Doug Dillinger. Doug Dillinger, of course, had a perfect 10 record in security for WCW for so many years. Nice stomp there by Ty Dillinger to Mark Henry, who makes the tag to Curtis Axel now. And Curtis Axel gets thrown away by Mark Henry's big legs. Look at this, picking up Curtis Axel for a power slam. And Curtis Axel's hurting. He's hurting right now. Going for the pin now. One. Only gonna be a two count. Only gonna be a one count, excuse me.
Man, my dude Mark Henry need to do a more. He need to do more than that if he wants to take out Mark Henry, man. Curtis Axel, you gotta do something, man. Aw, come on, man. Aren't closed fists illegal?
With the evolution of mixed martial arts, closed fists have actually been legalized in professional wrestling. Look at this, Curtis Axel with a beautiful dropkick there to Mark Henry. Paul Heyman keeps distracting Mark Henry. I don't know if anyone else has noticed that. He keeps distracting Mark Henry when he's in the ring there. I don't like that one damn bit.
Now, you know what? Too bad. The wrestlers should be paying attention to people in the ring. How many times do I gotta say it? Stop paying attention to Paul Heyman. Stop paying attention to anybody that's on the outside of the ring, man. Pay attention to your opponent, and maybe you won't lose the match because you're just being stupid, man.
Mark Henry with the belly-to-belly slam on Curtis Axel and then a big elbow across the ribs. Man, Curtis Axel is in trouble right now, Servo.
Ah, so one would think, but not yet. Okay, maybe he is in trouble. Nah, I got you. See, he ain't in trouble, I told you. Ha ha, got him.
Curtis Axel dropping a fist across the face of Mark Henry. Mark Henry kicks out. The greatest of ease.
Could be in the sand right now.
Oh no. Mark Henry picks him up again for a scoop slam. Oh, went for that chop, but it was blocked by Curtis Axel. He gets thrown off. Oh, and the world's strongest clothesline by Mark Henry. Well, Curtis is gonna wanna move right now. Oh my God! Mark Henry just smushed Curtis Axel.
You gotta be kidding me right now, player.
Listen to the crowd, they're loving it.
Mark Henry should be going for the pin. He's letting Curtis get up instead, and that's a mistake. A mistake that's gonna cost him, I'm telling you, player. We're gonna try to go for this powerbomb again. And Curtis ain't gonna have it. He got Ty Dillinger, who's a perfect 10. And then he himself, greater than perfect, man. Just better than perfect.
All right. Go for the cover now, one.
Go for the pin.
Only gonna be a one count.
All right, Mark Henry got out of it.
That's just
all right,
like that.
He run out of energy though, he's running low on that tank.
How much more does Curtis Axel have left too though? A drop kick, a thunderous drop kick by Curtis Axel. One. Only gonna be a one count that time. Mark Henry rolling out of the ring.
Well, he got lucky. He ain't too lucky now because Curtis Axel coming straight after.
But Mark Henry.
Oh, come on.
I don't think that's such a good idea to come after Mark Henry like that. The world's strongest man takes advantage. One punch, throws him in the ring, and already Curtis Axel down him. Is he? Maybe it's playing possum to get Mark Henry to come after him. Another drop kick takes down Mark Henry again. Curtis Axel going for that elbow to the middle rope. Didn't work out. And now Mark Henry making the tag to Apollo Crews. And Apollo off the turnbuckle. Taking it to the arm of Curtis Axel. He's got elbow pad over that arm too. It could either be the stronger arm or the weakest arm, depending on why he has an elbow pad over that elbow. Right now though, Ty Dillinger trying to stop Apollo Crews. Apollo Crews with a right hand and Ty Dillinger knocking him off the apron.
Come on, he didn't have to hit him that hard. Apollo Crews, man, he need to calm down.
Curtis Axel back up to his feet and stops Apollo Crews before he gets to the middle rope. Apollo's going for something higher risk, it looks like. A counter by Curtis Axel now. What's he gonna do here? For Apollo Crews, I should say. Curtis Axel off the ropes, runs into a drop kick by Apollo Crews. Curtis Axel, man, looking a little bit dizzy, looking a little tired. Now he gets kicked right in the face with the enziguri. Oh my goodness. Oh, look at this, Paul Heyman again. Paul Heyman keeps getting involved in this match.
Or they keep getting distracted by Paul Heyman when Paul Heyman's just minding his business on that side of the ring. Come on now, man. Can't be doing that. What is Curtis Axel doing right now, player?
We're watching the same. He's not going to superplex him on the outside, is he? Oh, my God, no. Curtis Axel sacrificing himself to take down Apollo Crews. And that's going to do a lot of damage to himself and mainly Apollo Crews. He makes the tag to Ty Dillinger, and Apollo has even moved since he hit the ground.
We said it many times before, man. You hit the outside of that ring, right, the outside of the floor right there, man. There's no giving it at all, man. That's concrete under there. There's a thin mat. Does not protect him all the way, man. Apollo Crews, his ribs might be busted up right now from that, man. His spine is tingling right now. He's hurt. He's about to get hurt even more by Ty Dillinger. Here we go.
Ty Dillinger. Your knee pad is down. There it is. The perfect 10.
Ah, player. But Mark Henry coming in now. Getting involved. Come on, man.
Apollo Crews, he was able to get shoulder up since Ty Dillinger started moving out of the way, but he was not able to move from Mark Henry. Mark Henry came in the ring and got him, but Apollo Crews still hasn't gotten up. He's in a lot of pain right now. He's taking a lot of damage here, but he's back up to his feet now, and Ty Dillinger doesn't even know it. Look at that German suplex. Apollo Crews waiting for Ty Dillinger to get back up to his feet so he can take him down here. He might be going for that springboard senton that we've seen before. But Ty Dillinger pushes him out of the way. Apollo rolling out of the way this time. He's doing everything he can right now to come back in this match because he's been in trouble. Ever since Curtis Axel hit that clothesline from the top rope, it was Ty Dillinger smacking him out of the way. But Apollo Crews, he's not giving up. Just yet, he's fighting back. Look at that stinger splash across the ring like that. Apollo Crews, oh my God.
That looks incredible, man. Looks great. Ty Dillinger is about to beat back on his feet just a moment. What up? All right, he got knocked back down. We gonna get back up. Don't worry about it, Clint.
Come on, this is getting ridiculous now. The referee needs to do something about Paul Heyman. Apollo Crews right now needs to stay focused on his opponent right now. He can't risk it losing this match because he's paying attention to Paul Heyman here. Or Ty Dillinger, I should say, since he's the illegal man now. Curtis Axel. Ty Dillinger taking advantage now with that double neck breaker. Mark Henry trying to get back in the ring here, but the referee's going to stop him. Going for the cover. One.
Okay.
And we're going to be a one count.
I'm surprised that was a one count, man. That should have been the end of the match right there. Apollo Crews been taking a lot of damage right now, player. Too much damage for him to handle.
Oh, Curtis runs into an elbow. Apollo has him where he needs him. And Mark, you gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my God, Mark Henry from the top rope. That's it, it's over. One. Super Ty Dillinger comes in and breaks it up. That would have been the end of the match right there. Uh-oh, Mark Henry's bringing Ty Dillinger back in the ring. Bad news for Ty Dillinger. Mark Henry with the world's strongest slam. Curtis Axel, man. Not doing much. Mark Henry takes care of him, too. Oh, Curtis Axel with the boot to the face. He throws him to the other corner. Takes down Mark Henry. Now Ty Dillinger's in the ring, so up.
Yeah, I'm watching the same match you watch, player. I'm paying attention.
I'm just making sure.
Listen, man. Ty Dillinger right now, he got the whole match in his hands right now because Mark Henry's down. Uh-oh. It looks like Ty Dillinger's about to fly. Looking for a neck breaker right now. A buff, block, buster. And Mark Henry, oh, play. Ty Dillinger got him with a senton instead. Doesn't like he got all the... And that wasn't enough to put him away, man. If he would've got all of it, probably would've been in the match. Uh-oh. Player. Oh, Mark Henry's mad now. Oh, player, come on, man. He wasn't even, what are you doing? He's not even in the match, and you over there putting your hands on the guy. See, this is why he gonna lose the match, because he's too distracted by people. They ain't even in the match. That's his problem right now.
Oh! A boot to the back of the head of Ty Dillinger, and then he tackles Curtis Axel off the apron. Ty Dillinger's out of it. Mark Henry now has him in the corner and just completely eviscerated Ty Dillinger in the corner right now. Mark Henry's in control of the match. Ty Dillinger, he doesn't know where he's at right now. The world's strongest power bomb on Ty Dillinger. Oh, come on now. Paul Heyman again getting involved. Are you kidding me?
Mark Henry should be paying attention to his opponent, not Paul Heyman. Look, Ty Dillinger got back up to his feet.
Oh, the crucifix.
Going for the cover.
From Ty Dillinger. He's
got
him. Oh, no.
He got him. Ty Dillinger and Curtis Axel with a match.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, but that's what Mark Henry did. He should have been paying attention. Instead, he decided he wanted to talk some mess with Paul Heyman, and that's what cost him the match here tonight, man.
He should have ever turned his back on Ty Dillinger like that. He should have been paying attention to Paul Heyman. Well, here tonight, Ty Dillinger and Curtis Axel pick up the victory, a hard-won victory at that. The Apollo Crews and Mark Henry, I think they had the upper hand in the match until the end, where Paul Heyman distracted Mark Henry, and then Ty Dillinger was able to take advantage of this, that power bomb. But then Paul Heyman here distracted Mark Henry. And look at this, Ty Dillinger, meanwhile in the background, he gets back up to his feet with everything he's got left. He takes down Mark Henry, keeps him down to the mat. Mark Henry had nowhere to go. He couldn't escape. It was all over. And that's a big win for Ty Dillinger and Curtis Axel here tonight. Could they be future tag team champions here in WCW. They keep it up. Maybe they'll be able to compete against John Cena and Randy Orton.
Man, there's no doubt in my mind these two are the next tag team champions of the world, man. They will definitely be tag team champions because they got Paul Heyman by their side, telling them all that knowledge that they need to know.
Well, up next, the Icon Sting returns, or does he? We still don't know, but we're about to find out up next. Dolph Ziggler versus Sting. The Icon Sting is supposed to be back. This is going to be big.
Yeah, Sting disappeared like he always usually does, and now he's supposed to be back, but we don't know that. The NWO, man, I'm telling you, man, they're going to take him out.
Okay, first we're going to have Carmella versus Nia Jax instead. The graphic said that Sting and Dolph Ziggler was up next. Oh well, we're going to have that right after this though. First, Carmella taking on the WCW Women's Champion. This is a non-title match. Nia Jax has been undefeated though. She's been unstoppable. Hopefully for Carmella, hopefully Asuka will be able to try to help her in this match. Help her get a victory over Nia Jax, maybe.
There ain't no way in hell that's gonna happen, man. I'm gonna admit to you right now, Asuka has a much better chance than Carmella at beating Nia Jax when she gets her match at WCW New Blood Rising for the WCW World Women's Championship. But until then, right now, Nia Jax better be focused. Excuse me, Carmella better be focused right now.
Nia Jax.
Because Nia Jax is nothing to mess with right now, man. Nothing to play with. Nia Jax will destroy her. But she's got Ted DiBiase by her side too, man. A Million Dollar Man. That's a great investment for a Million Dollar Man right now. I'm just saying. Look at this.
Here comes the unstoppable Nia Jax. With the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase by her side. The World Women's Champion here in World Championship Wrestling. She's been destructive ever since she won that championship. She won this match. Remember, Asuka's still undefeated too. Nia Jax and Asuka are still undefeated, and they're going to be going at New Blood Rising. Who's going to be the first one to take a defeat? And Nia Jax, the World Women's Champion. She won that title in a Battle Royal match with Asuka. Asuka was eliminated. It does not count as a loss since it was a Battle Royal. She was eliminated when she got thrown over the top rope. She still hasn't been pinned or submitted. She's still undefeated today. So she wants her title back, but she's going to have to go through Nia Jax if she wants that title back. She's out here, I'm sure, to scout this match and see what Nia Jax is made of here against Carmella. I wish Carmella the best in this match. Hopefully she does well. Here we go. Carmella going straight after her. Runs right into a brick wall there. She's doing a good job so far. But Nia Jax, watch out here. Oh, she moves out of the way. Look at that. And a knee to the back takes down Carmella. And now Carmella is in trouble.
To be honest, man, I think Carmella was in trouble when the bell rung. Hell, not even that. She was in trouble when she looked at the card and saw she was booked up against Nia Jax, man. But you gotta give it to Shane McMahon. He's trying to give Carmella a chance here. A win over the champion? That's an automatic championship match, man. So if Carmella could somehow defeat Nia Jax, that could be great for her because she's been on a losing streak lately. So it doesn't even matter right now. She needs something, anything, man. Anything to get up there in the ranks. Nia Jax is just destroying her like she usually do.
Carmella having trouble right now. We saw Nia Jax take on Bayley and just destroy Bayley at the last pay-per-view event. And now New Blood Rising. She's going to have to be focused on Asuka. She's really going to have to be focused on Asuka. Asuka's a different beast in there too. Jax didn't get everything on that last attack there. But Carmella's still trying to get back up to her feet now. Ooh, right back into the corner though. Headbutt. She's going to do it again, and that time she got all of it. if not more, than she got before. The leg drop on Carmella. And goes for the cover. But Carmella quickly kicking out even before a one count.
That's surprising.
You got Asuka there.
Yeah, Asuka's distracting Nia Jax. You got anything to say about that?
Nia Jax doesn't want
it. She's over here distracting Nia Jax, just like we saw before in a match previous with Paul Heyman.
Asuka's not distracting. Okay,
look, she getting up on the apron. What do you call that?
Well, she wasn't distracting Nia Jax. So she, all right, she might be trying to distract Nia Jax now.
She is. She distracted Nia Jax, man. But it's all good. Because now Carmella, all she doing is she going to make Nia Jax even angrier. There we go. Just like that. Gets turned. Uh-oh. Come on, Nia.
Jesus!
Bam! Ran over like a truck, bro.
Nia Jax in trouble. Or Carmella's in trouble right now. Nia Jax is... Oh, but that super kick didn't work from Carmella. And Nia Jax again off. Oh. I'm surprised she didn't take Carmella down there. Well, that time she just destroys Carmella though. Oh my God. And this is what ended Bayley. Choke slam. Carmella goes down. Oh no, don't do this. Come on. This is just too much now. Asuka getting up on the apron now. We'll see Asuka versus Nia Jax at WCW New Blood Rising. Wait a minute here now.
Oh, player man, she better back up before she gets smacked up.
You might see them both go at it right now.
Asuka and Carmella right now trying to set up Nia Jax. I'm telling you, player. But it ain't gonna happen. I wish this was a two-on-one match, just so Nia Jax could beat both of them at the same time. Would have been great, man. But it's all good. One-on-one, that's fine. Give her a fair opportunity and watch her lose.
Nia Jax tossing.
Oh my God.
Nia Jax. She is making a statement right now to Asuka. Asuka doesn't look too concerned right now, though, about Nia Jax.
Look at Asuka right now, again.
Nia Jax right now, if anything, she's distracting herself because Asuka hasn't done anything to get her attention right now.
Oh, man. Asuka got that loud hair that's over here distracting Nia Jax. That's what it is. And these clothes. I mean, come on, man. Who wears a thong over the wrestling attire, player? It's supposed to be under. I don't know what they do in Japan, player, but this ain't right. She an American now. She need to get things right. The old good way, like the old USA way, of America. Yeah.
Ooh, a chop across the chest by Nia Jax on Carmella. Brutal shots right now. Now Nia Jax. Oh no. Now Nia is in the Asuka. Maybe trying to help Carmella out here. Distracting Nia Jax right now. That time she was distracting her. I'll give you
of
that.
Of course. That's what she's been doing throughout the whole match, man. You can't tell me that she has been. Look at this. Asuka needs to leave right now. The referee needs to kick her out right now. He's not even paying attention to Asuka. Come on, man.
A drop kick to the back of the head of Nia Jax. Gonna go for the cover here and try to feed her right now. Two.
No way.
She did. She ended the streak.
Wait a minute. No. That's not. No. This is BS right now, man. This is some bull crap. Asuka was distracting Nia Jax that whole time right now, player.
It's not going to happen.
This match.
It's not going to happen. Nia Jax, look at this. A drop kick to the back of the head. Knocking Nia Jax out. And Carmella takes advantage. Hooks the leg. Pins the champion. Winner here now on WCW Nitro. What a match here tonight from Carmella and Nia Jax. I can't believe Carmella actually got the victory. And Asuka is taking... Asuka's the only one that's defeated, that's undefeated now in WCW in the women's division. What's going to happen with Asuka and Nia Jax at New Blood Rising?
Man, you better believe it's going to be a revenge is on the way for it. I'm telling you, man. Nia Jax is going to completely destroy Asuka after that.
And ladies and gentlemen, I can confirm that Dolph Ziggler and Sting is next. Here tonight, is Sting here? We're about to find out next this time. But still to come here tonight on WCW Nitro as well, we're going to see Okada versus Billy Gunn, the IWGP World Champion. We'll be going up against Billy Gunn. The title's not on the line though. If Billy Gunn could get a win over Okada, though, that would be huge. What's going to happen tonight, too? The World Championship. We still don't know what's happening at New Blood Rising. But also in our main event here tonight, Nitro, we're going to see Samoa Joe, the World Champion, teaming up with the United States Heavyweight Champion Shinsuke Nakamura. They're going to go up against the NWO's Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows. What's going to happen when those two teams clash? Here tonight at WCW Nitro. And now it's the moment of truth. Is the Icon Sting here? We're about to find out.
Just the first hour right now, but I'm telling you, just the first hour of WCW Nitro. And we got Dolph Ziggler taking on Sting. Sting ain't even gonna show up though, man. Dolph Ziggler, I hate to disappoint the fans, I really do. But he ain't gonna show up. He saw the car, he saw he's taking on Dolph Ziggler, he said forget about it. I'm going home again. Taking his ball, going home, you know. It's funny how CM Punk get in trouble for that, how Stone Cold get in trouble for that, how Brock Lesnar get in trouble for that. But Sting doesn't. Everybody's okay with it. They don't care. I hate that. I hate Sting. I hate the Wolfpack. I don't hate the Wolfpack.
Uh-oh.
That's Kevin Nash's group, by the way. Copyrighted by him.
Here we go. The Icon Sting is back. The former multiple time WCW World Champion, former TNA World Heavyweight Champion, former NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Sting has done it all in this wrestling business. He's went up against some of the greats and all of the greats. The Icon Sting making his way to the ring right now. Listen to this crowd. Welcome Sting back.
The Icon Sting, man, he may be back, but he about to be laying on his back in about a few moments by Dolph Ziggler, I'm telling you. Look at him pointing his back. Is he going to try to use his bat right now, player? He's been known to use it before.
Dolph Ziggler now starting the match off. And Sting getting ran into the barricade. And oh, come on now. He's going to use the bat on Sting. Something's a little off about Sting.
Well, he's been gone for about a few weeks or about a month or two. His hair's going to get longer, man. Dolph Ziggler taking him out with that baseball bat that he brought to the ring. So you can't say nothing about it, man. He's the one that brought it to the ring. He was the one that was intending on using it. And it got used on him. There's the bell, and here we go. The Icon Sting is back.
And then Sting taking a beam right now from Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler's doing a lot of damage to Sting right now. Something just seems a little off about Sting right now, in my opinion.
He's supposed to be representing the Wolfpack, but he's not wearing any red. He's wearing black and white. That's NWO Cup. So right now, he's in danger of being beat down just because he's not wearing the colors. Actually, you know, it doesn't even matter if he's wearing the Wolfpack colors because that's Kevin Nash's group. He cracked the Wolfpack.
Let's see what happens here. Sting is having trouble getting things going in his... He's going by so fast. Dolph Ziggler couldn't even catch him that time, but the clothesline takes him down as Sting tries to come back in. I'm telling you, the Famouser by Dolph Ziggler on Sting. Sting trying to get back up to his feet right now.
Man, Sting,
I don't think that's Sting.
That's gotta be Sting. He got the face paint, he's got the gear, he's got the music, everything. That's Sting right there, player. What are you talking about right now?
Drop kick by Dolph Ziggler. Just something is off. It doesn't seem right. I don't think that's Sting.
That is Sting right now. Dolph Ziggler just hit Sting with the Stinger Splash. And now Sting is in trouble. Dolph Ziggler's in full control of this match. He's about to kick his whole head off right now in a minute if he's not careful. Dolph Ziggler, man, has it easy. He's a young upcomer. Sting, on the other hand, he needs to retire already, Flair. I mean, he still looks good. He's in great shape and everything. But he just needs to hang up the boots already, Flair. That neck ain't gonna hold up forever.
And now Dolph Ziggler. Oh! Across the back with Sting. By Sting. Clothesline. Clothesline again. Maybe it is Sting. Sting is in control this match here. Stinger Splash. Dolph Ziggler's down and out. And now here we go. As the Icon Sting tries to get back in control here with the clothesline. Scorpion Deathlock turns Dolph Ziggler over, and there it is. But I'm telling you, that doesn't look like Sting to me.
Just be quiet, alright, player. You're still saying it's not Sting. It's clearly the Icon Sting. He's got the the Scorpion Deathlock locked in, everything. And Dolph Ziggler escapes. Dolph Ziggler escapes right now, player. Now Dolph Ziggler's about to show him how it's done. Sting just doesn't have as much power as he used to back in the day right now, man. He was going up against Ric Flair. He's about to get his head kicked off. Here we go. Here we go. Oh,
sweet kid music.
Sting's head off, man.
Shawn Michaels has taken Dolph Ziggler under his wing as of late. And the NWO is trying their best to get some kind of momentum going. And right now on Sting, it looks like they may be doing that. Dolph Ziggler with the heart attack right now. With those elbow drops on Sting over and over again, and Sting's in trouble. He should have went for the cover and pinned him, but he actually didn't even go for the pin. I'm surprised by that.
Well, I'm sure after he got caught in Sting's greatest move, he thought to himself, you know what? This ain't that bad. I'm about to have fun now. And that's what he's doing right now. Sting has been away. For all we know, this is a lot of ring rust on Sting. And he's just out of shape now. He hasn't been working out, training, or anything right now. Ref, what are you doing right now, player?
What is Dolph Ziggler doing with the baseball bat? Oh! Sting takes advantage, though. Going for the cover. One. Oh, Dolph Ziggler kicks out at one. And the referee going to get that baseball bat out of the ring, though. This isn't a no disqualification match. But Sting is going after the bat. This is uncharacteristic of
What the hell you mean it's uncharacteristic? He's the one known for bringing in the bat. He got kicked in his face for trying to use it. All those times he used the bat on the NWO. Are you kidding me? Dolph Ziggler put the end to the big scary man here tonight, Sting. He's no competition for Dolph Ziggler here tonight, man. No competition at all.
That's not Sting. I'm telling you, that is not Sting.
Get by my face with that, right? That is Sting. It's clearly Sting. Don't give me that BS about how it's not Sting. Dolph Ziggler just beat Sting tonight. You ain't making no excuses for Sting here tonight, man. He he should cut his hair, maybe dye blonde, maybe people will think he's different next week. Who knows? But right now, he needs to hit the gym, because he is out of shape, man. He has so much ring rust, he's an embarrassment to World Championship Wrestling after tonight. Not to take anything away from Dolph Ziggler. I mean, but you can see how desperate Sting got there when he got that baseball bat.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ethan Carr III has arrived. He is here tonight. Wait a minute, what the hell? Look, the Sting! The real Sting is here! I told you that was a fake Sting! The real Sting is here, and he's back on WCW Nitro!
Man, it doesn't matter, though, because Dolph Ziggler is still beating him down right now. Dolph Ziggler's still doing work. A perk! What's Sting doing with that baseball bat? He can't fight like a man? He needs a weapon?
No, he doesn't need a weapon. He's not going to use it on Dolph Ziggler. Sting is going to fight Dolph Ziggler with his own fist here tonight. Oh, no. Now, Dolph Ziggler getting the advantage, though, on Sting. And Sting thrown right into the corner. A sweet chin. No, he missed. Scorpion death drop by Sting. Wow! Sting is back!
The hottest music! The IWGP Heavyweight Champion has now come to the ring here.
Of course, Okada's the world champion of New Japan Pro Wrestling, but he's here in WCW right now. Who is this? What's going on right now, Flash?
Samoa Joe, he has his guard up just in case right now. But Cobra Clutch is locked in on Samoa Joe. He's got that towel around his neck, too. And he takes down Samoa Joe. He wants to make that title his. Oh, and a back elbow by Samoa Joe. Oh, but this choke slam might be the end of it here for Samoa Joe. No, Samoa Joe with the elbow.
I gotta get props to Samoa Joe, man. Doing a great job.
Big Show, I'm going to pay attention here. The steel chair.
Ah, right.
And chops him across
no.
the ring. Oh, here we go. Muscle Buster. By Samoa Joe. Takes down the Big Show inside. Beat him at Christmas Chaos. And once again, Samoa Joe. One, two, three. No.
No way.
Big Show actually got the shoulder up this time.
The Big Show got it up.
No.
God. Jab shot to the head.
That's
going to
choke slam. Yeah, Samoa Joe by the throat. And now the Samoan submission machine. No, a rake to the eyes. Able to escape it. And Samoa Joe with a thunderous kick to the face. Flying across the ring. Samoa Joe showing his agility right now. Table
I'm
serve
loving
up.
It. I'm loving it.
This
man.
Might be the end of Samoa Joe
this
here.
This is the end of Samoa Joe. He going for a ride. Oh my God.
Maybe there is.
No.
Maybe Samoa Joe has something left. Look at this.
How's it still going right now? Come on, man. I'm watching the end of the streak from Samoa Joe. Damn it.
Samoa Joe is not giving up.
Slam his ass through the ring. Oh, right.
Takes down Big Show with that modified ST Joe, it looks like. And Samoa Joe picks up the victory with that move. No freaking way. What? But he's contracted to... Wait a minute. What? Shane McMahon just hired Ethan Carter III to WCW. What the hell is going on here?
Not only that, but a World Heavyweight title match against Samoa Joe!
And this week on WCW Nitro, there is no attack from Billy Gunn, thankfully. He's going to be involved in a match later on tonight with Okada. So let's see now what Ethan Carter the Third has to say. He's going to speak to the fans here tonight on Nitro about what happened, what went down last week, I'm assuming. Take it to EC3. Two-time World Heavyweight Champion already. Can he make it to EC3 time at New Blood Rising? Is he still competing to get Samoa Joe? We'll hear from Shane McMahon hopefully later on tonight. Here comes the WCW president, Shane McMahon. And what's he gonna say regarding the World Championship match at New Blood Rising and Ethan Carter's request to take on Billy Gunn? From what we understand, it's still gonna be Samoa Joe and EC3 so far, but Shane may make changes right now and put EC3 in two matches in one night. Okada, from what we understand, hasn't been booked yet. What's gonna happen with his situation? He's going up against Billy Gunn
tonight. Put the IWGP title on the line against Billy tonight. If Billy wins, he takes on Ethan Carter III for two titles. This is gonna be a four-way match.
This
Are
Sunday.
You kidding me?
This Sunday, WCW New Blood Rising. Well, next we're gonna see Billy Gunn take on Okada, ladies and gentlemen. Could Billy Gunn and Okada be the future WCW World Heavyweight Champion by next week? The next time we see WCW Nitro. That all happens at New Blood Rising, just moments ago announced from Shane McMahon. This is incredible. We're going to see Billy Gunn, Okada, EC3, and Samoa Joe in a four-way match for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, no, man. If I'm Samoa Joe, I'm pissed off at Shane McMahon right now for stacking the deck against me. Samoa Joe, he's only supposed to be taking on one man in New Blood Rising, whether that's EC3 or Okada or even Billy Gunn. But now he's taking on all three.
Also saw a streak come to an end here tonight. Nia Jax's streak is over. Can Samoa Joe keep his streak intact here tonight against Karl Anderson and Luke Gallows as he teams up with Shinsuke Nakamura? Billy Gunn has a very serious look on his face. How's the outcome of this match gonna change for Billy Gunn and Okada right now? These two have a World Heavyweight Championship match in the main event at New Blood Rising now. And Ethan Carr III, he's supposed to make his debut at New Blood Rising. That's why he's not competing here tonight. I'm sure Shane McMahon is going to put them in the ring together here tonight in some capacity, but we're going to see them all four do battle at New Blood Rising. This is incredible. Now, here comes the current IWGP World Heavyweight Champion for New Japan Pro Wrestling, Okada, making his way to the ring. He may be the undisputed champion walking out of WCW New Blood Rising this Sunday.
Yo, man, there's a lot that Billy Gunn has to prove, man. He ain't got too many world championship matches in his past, man, let's be honest. And now he has an opportunity at the WCW World Heavyweight Championship. He better make the best of this opportunity. Because it's not going to come too soon, man. It's not going to come too often. I mean, he needs to make the best of it. I'm telling you, man. This is incredible. It's amazing.
We'll see what happens. Okada. Billy Gunn. The Rainmaker, Mr. Ass, going at it here tonight. Billy Gunn and Alexa Bliss haven't had too much success together. They've had success separately when you think about it. Billy Gunn has himself a world championship match. He's been having a winning streak as of late too, himself. He's been pretty much undefeated, kind of. Billy Gunn has been on fire since he's been here in WCW, since his debut, since he's teamed up with Alexa Bliss, forming the Assassins. And Billy Gunn right now, look how aggressive he is in this match. We still don't know why he attacked EC3 last week, but maybe it was to get a world championship match. Maybe it was to put his hat, maybe put his name in that hat. Once he saw Okada challenging Samoa Joe, once he saw EC3, he was already going to get a world championship match before we even knew it was EC3 getting the world championship match. Billy Gunn has won a lot of matches here in WCW, so he does deserve this opportunity that he's getting at WCW New Blood Rising. And Okada, of course, IWGP world champion, he deserves it as well. Former WCW tag team champion.
The thing that's tough about WCW is there's a lot of guys that deserve the opportunity at world championship, man. I could see any of these guys wearing that world heavyweight championship because they are so talented. But there's a lot of guys going after it. That just makes Samoa Joe just look that much stronger, man. Look at Sting, Goldberg, Kevin Nash, Dolph Ziggler, Okada, Billy Gunn, EC3. The list goes on and on, man. They all want to be the World Heavyweight Champion, but there can only be one World Heavyweight Champion, and that one World Champion is the undefeated Samoan Submission Machine, Samoa Joe. But I hope he loses at New Blood Rising. Me personally, I hope Billy Gunn actually wins the title, surprisingly.
Why is that, though? Why do you think that Billy Gunn should win the World Heavyweight Championship? Why now?
Listen, man, I haven't liked Billy Gunn as of late, man. We did to Rikishi, my dude Rikishi. That was wrong, man. We did to Buddy Murphy. It was wrong, man. But it's all good because I like this new attitude of Billy Gunn. When he came out and beat down EC3 last week, I liked it. And I want to see more of this. I hope he can keep it up, man. I hope he keeps it going. I hope that he becomes a world champion, and this aggression that he's found last week, I hope he can keep it going, man. Because Billy Gunn, look at that, man. He's always been the more talented one in DX when he was teaming up with Road Dogg. Road Dogg, man, come on, man. He was great on the mic. He said a lot of fancy words. But Billy Gunn, he was the technical assassin of that team, man. He was so great. And it's a shame that he was never the World Heavyweight Champion.
That is true. Billy Gunn could become the World Heavyweight Champion, though, at WCW New Blood Rising. Okada could be the World Champion as well. Look at this. A powerbomb from Billy Gunn countered by Okada. And this has been an incredible match as well. Okada with a drop kick to the chest of Billy Gunn. Billy Gunn tries to get up. Okada pushes him back down and goes for the pin. And Billy Gunn kicks out. Billy Gunn's got to be careful, man, because nobody's ever kicked out of that Rainmaker. And now Billy Gunn in trouble. A suplex by Okada goes for the pin again. The IWGP World Champion. He still can't believe it. Billy Gunn kicked out that soon, but he did. Billy Gunn, of course, has been in New Japan Pro Wrestling as well. So Okada and Billy Gunn should be a little bit familiar with each other. Billy Gunn, a part of the Bullet Club Hunters with Yoshitatsu. Haven't been too successful, though, to be honest. Okada kicks Billy Gunn back down into the corner. And now Okada. Watch out now, off the ropes. Went for an uppercut, but Billy Gunn rolls out of the way.
You know, maybe Billy Gunn hasn't been paying attention to Alexa Bliss as of late because, you know, maybe Alexa Bliss, he doesn't want her to hold him down. Diamond cutter from Billy Gunn.
You might have a point there. He's going, hooking the leg here, going for the cover, trying to win the match here. Bokata kicks out the last second. Billy Gunn has been with Yoshitatsu in New Japan Pro Wrestling. Has Yoshitatsu held Billy Gunn down? That's a good question there. And now Billy Gunn going for a power slam. Oh, a heavy power slam by Billy Gunn. Look at his headlock now. I like how he repositioned Okada there so he could get him closer away from the ropes. I should say, away from the ropes, Billy Gunn. And he's got this headlock locked in, trying to wear Okada down right now. Do damage to that neck. It'll be good once he hits that famouser. He lets go of the hold and picks him back up. Well, Okada gets up to his feet and gets knocked down with that lariat by Billy Gunn. And this is a good attitude. I'll agree with that serve up, what you said earlier. This is a great attitude for Billy Gunn because he's got the IWGP champion right now on the rails right now. Okada still not backing down just yet. Billy Gunn going to go for another powerbomb, but Okada with another counter. Another reversal here. Oh, nice left hand.
It's definitely worth it for Billy Gunn, man. He's got to keep it up if he wants to be a World Heavyweight Champion next week. Imagine seeing the World Heavyweight Championship around the waist of Billy Gunn. I know a lot of people make fun of Billy Gunn, how his career was a failure after he became the King of the Ring. He got injured, man. But Billy Gunn was never a failure in my opinion. Look at the success he had with Chuck Palumbo going for the cover here and a kick out. Billy Gunn was on top of the world with Chuck Palumbo. It's surprising that he didn't go anywhere afterwards. He would, though, show up in TNA. Had a lot of success there with Road Dogg once again. They turned his back on Road Dogg. Thought he had enough, man. He was enough being a team. Road Dogg got selfish. He wanted to become tag team champions with his father, Bullet Bob Armstrong. And Billy Gunn was like, nah, I'm not having any of that. So he turned his back on Road Dogg, man. Then he aligned himself with the Beautiful People, which was the smartest thing ever for Billy Gunn, man. Billy Gunn, the Beautiful People.
Wait, look at Okada. Look at this. Over the top, bro.
Play.
Wow. And Okada takes out Billy Gunn now. Billy Gunn is in trouble. Okada should probably went for the pinfall there, in my opinion. Okada with the dropkick. He dropkicked Billy Gunn so hard, Billy Gunn went flying over the top rope, right out of the ring. Alright, I'm getting word right now that we're getting cameras backstage here. Kane, a SmackDown superstar, is
now Okada's got to work hard just to get back in the ring.
It's Kane.
He's got to pick him up and get back in the ring. But Billy Gunn right now, he got his hands on him, kicking him away, his feet on him anyway.
You got to be careful here. Referee
now Billy Gunn. Oh, play. Oh, right to the barricade. Thing is padded up. It still does a lot of damage, I'm telling you. Just stomping and punching Billy Gunn right now. Okada needs to get him in the ring right now, player.
It's like they've lost control in this match so far now. Oh my god, Billy Gunn with a clothesline wrapping that arm around the neck of Okada right now. Oh no, they've just been counted out here. This is what I was talking about earlier. Kane is a SmackDown superstar, but oh my god, what the hell? Kane's attacking his own brother with that briefcase.
Looks like little brother got tired of being disrespected. Came on an A show, ready to take out The Undertaker. Kane might be joining the NWO, man. Undertaker ain't staying down. He gonna have to keep picking that briefcase up and beating him down with it.
The Big Red Machine, Kane, from SmackDown. He's still contracted SmackDown superstar. Oh, the chair against the ribs of Undertaker. We saw an imposter Sting earlier tonight. I don't think that's Kane.
Oh my god, here we go again. You was right the first time, I give you that. But that's definitely Kane.
No, that's not Kane. That is not Kane. Look how tall The Undertaker is compared to Kane. Kane has always been taller than The Undertaker. He's always been the bigger little brother.
But wait a minute, look at this. If that's not Kane, then why is he about to chokeslam the hell out of The Undertaker right now, player? Explain to me that. He just chokeslammed Undertaker straight to hell.
This is part of the NWO. This has to be some setup by the NWO. That's not Kane. That is not the real Kane, ladies and gentlemen. The real Kane is on SmackDown. And The Undertaker just got assaulted by a mystery man, by an imposter. That is not Kane. Kane is much bigger than that.
Here we go with the Miss Beautiful Dana Brooke, making her way to the ring right now.
Last week we saw Alexa Bliss and Dana Brooke go at it. She was challenged to a bare body beatdown match at WCW New Blood Rising. We'll see that this Sunday. The stipulation of the match is simple. It'll be a normal match, but they'll be in their swim gear, their swimsuits, battling out. Challenge made by Dana Brooke after she claims Alexa Bliss is only known for her quote fat greasy ass.
And that's all she is known for, man. That's why she with Billy Gunn. That's all they got going for him right now. Nothing else. But look at this. Look at Dana Brooke. She's a beast in that ring, player. She has unreal strength and power. And she has the most beautiful physique in WCW, involving even the men, definitely the men.
Yeah, well,
especially the men.
Okay, we got this has got to be pretty. This has got to probably hit Alexa Bliss real strong, because of course she's in the past, her personal life, she's battled with anorexia. And just hearing that from Dana Brooke, that's got to be deep right there. That's got to really piss Alexa Bliss off, calling her fat. And she is not fat at all.
Are you kidding me? You see how fat her ass? Man, come on, player. You must be blind.
Come on, man. Come on. Alexa Bliss, She's got to be watching this match right now, getting ready for New Blood Rising. Dana Brooke, so disrespectful to Alexa Bliss last week on here on Nitro. Definitely made her angry. And hopefully Alexa Bliss can use that to her advantage, though, to take out.
Well, we got pinfall right now. Quick kick out.
Kick out, like I was saying. Hopefully she can use that to her advantage to take out Dana Brooke at WCW New Blood Rising. And by the way, Dana Brooke is taking on a young athlete trying to make a name for herself in this business by the name of Cynthia Sharp. See how good she can do here tonight against Dana Brooke. Dana with the DDT. Gonna go for the cover here. That might be it. A kick out. And of course, Natalya Neidhart watching over Dana Brooke here. Dana Brooke is a member of the Horsemen Foundation, a team that was founded. Nice pun there. But anyways, founded by Bret Hart, Jim Neidhart, and Ric Flair, and Charlotte Flair, but unfortunately, and Natalya Neidhart, but unfortunately, Ric Flair and Charlotte Flair not part of Nitro. At least Charlotte Flair had signed for resignation. So hopefully maybe we'll see her in the future on SmackDown. She is no longer a part of WCW after what happened last week with Ric Flair and Austin Aries.
Well, Shane McMahon suspended him indefinitely. But I heard that Ric Flair is talking to Shane McMahon right now about that. So I don't know what's going on, player, but it's wrong that they suspended Austin Aries.
He definitely deserved to get suspended after what he did last week.
Well, I enjoy seeing Austin Aries wrestle in the ring, okay? He did deserve to get suspended. We did last week? Yeah, he went too far, man. I was cringing a lot at last week what happened, especially when he kicked him in his face, man. That was just
disgusting.
Messed up. Look at this power right now. Look at this from Dana Brooke, man. She's so powerful.
Yeah, Dana Brooke, so impressive in the ring. We don't see this very often. She hasn't been competing in WCW as of late. Maybe that is another reason why she turned on her then tag team partner Alexa Bliss in that match against Charlotte and Natalya 2 weeks ago. She wanted to get the spotlight back on her finally. She's still trying to make a name for herself. Teaming up with Natalya Neidhart might be what she needs. Look at this power again from Dana Brooke. Cynthia Sharp, she doesn't have a lot of weight on her, but she does have that height advantage. And Dana Brooke picking her up off of her feet, even when she's taller than Dana, it's impressive. Went for a drop kick and missed, though. Cynthia swatted away, hits her with a drop kick of her own. Cynthia doesn't want to get too cocky, though. Showing some confidence here. The clothesline. Another clothesline. But Dana Brooke gets back up. Third one. Got a little dizzy. She's in the corner now. Oh! Went for a shoulder block. Dana Brooke moves out of the way. Cynthia Sharp able to counter, though, that Samoan drop attempt. That fireman's carry from Dana Brooke.
That was real impressive. I like that. That was real nice to see. Cynthia Sharp is going for a sharpshooter.
Gonna try to embarrass Dana Brooke here on Nitro, but Dana Brooke's under the ropes. She has a grab. She has to grab that apron. Oh, kick over the back now. Cynthia Sharp, what's she doing? Look at this, a chop across the chest. Look like a little bit of Scotty Too Hotty right there. Gonna go for the cover here. Here we go. Not gonna be even a one count for Dana Brooke. Dana Brooke, oh, she gets kicked in the spine, but that just made her mad. Another kick. Dana Brooke moves out of the way. A chop across the chest. Taking down Cynthia Sharp now. Oh, she's going for a sidewalk slam. It gets countered into a DDT. And Dana Brooke goes down. Can Cynthia Sharp get an upset victory here? No. The rookie isn't able to get Dana Brooke just yet. And Dana Brooke, she was a rookie not too long ago herself. So she knows what that could do for Cynthia Sharp and how embarrassing it would be for herself if she lost this match. Dana Brooke with a drop kick. And a clothesline.
She wanna go over there and do these fancy clotheslines. Dana Brooke gonna show her how to do a clothesline. Uh-oh, look at the look in Cynthia's face right now, Claire. That was fear. And Dana Brooke, she didn't even have a hard time lifting her up like that, Claire. Just complete domination from Dana Brooke right now. Picking her up again. And slamming her with that Samoan driver.
What a nice move there by Dana Brooke. Usually puts her opponents away, but she's just... Now she's just taunting the crowd right now. Rather than going for the win for whatever reason. Gonna drag her to the middle of the ring here to put her away, or maybe not. Oh, what an elbow drop right there. Could this end it? Why'd she stop covering? Come on now. Who she think she is, Scott Steiner now?
Man. She's got the biggest arms in the women's division here in WCW right now, player, I'm telling you. The only one I see with big arms as big as Dana Brooke is probably China. That's the only way I can really compare her. Compared to the legendary China, man.
China, man.
What?
Nothing. Anyways, right now, Dana Brooke. Oh, God, right by the throat. What is this? A military press into a power slam. Hook in the leg. That might be it right here. That's it. Dana Brooke showing off her power here tonight. Showing off that athleticism that she wants to bring to WCW New Blood Rising when she goes up against Alexa Bliss. But Alexa Bliss will not be a walk in the park. Wait a minute. Alexa Bliss is coming down to the ring right
Talk
now.
About, you gotta be kidding me, man. I wanna see these replays from Dana Brooke, man.
Look at
this. Is BS. What is she doing?
Alexa, get
there
oh, no.
There we go. Dana Brooke threw her out of the ring. She's trying to come up with a sneak attack on Dana Brooke. It ain't gonna happen. Not tonight. Hell no. It ain't even gonna happen in New Blood Rising. Come on, Claire.
We almost saw what happened last
week. She over here chasing her again like we saw last week on Nitro. Come on.
And this time, she catches up with Dana Brooke and takes her out. Alexa Bliss. All this aggression and anger towards Dana Brooke. Good God, she kicked her right in her face, I think. The back of the face, one of them. She kicked the hell out of Dana Brooke. Oh, and then rams her head first into the ring post. What's she doing now? She's getting a kendo stick. Are you kidding me? Look at this. Alexa Bliss is going crazy on Dana Brooke right now.
She needs to be arrested. She needs to be taken to jail for this. Somebody get a nightstick and just beat the hell out of her right now, player. This is wrong. Oh, come on, player. Alexa Bliss just beating the hell out of Dana Brooke right now. Smacking her all around the ring. It's beating it so bad, they probably have to censor it, man. And for what? Trying to prove something right now, player? Oh, come on.
Alexa Bliss with a beat down on Dana Brooke here tonight on Monday Nitro. And she's not done yet. Look at this. Twisted Bliss. A Dana Brooke here on Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, up next here on WCW Monday Nitro, we're going to see Jack Swagger, the All-American American, versus the American Hero, the Patriot Dose.
The Patriot Dose. Yeah, it says Kurt Angle right there, man. That's Kurt Angle.
We don't know that for sure. Jack Swagger could be the Patriot Dose for all we know. We might not see this match.
I'm getting real sick and tired of these stupid excuses, to be honest, Hypnosis.
Also still to come here tonight, Shinsuke Nakamura and Samoa Joe team up to take on Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows. We're going to go down the card for New Blood Rising. We got some big matches that have just been announced, ladies and gentlemen. So don't go anywhere. We're going to figure out what we're going to reveal those matches right after this match.
Here we go with the Olympic gold medalist, American hero, Kurt Angle, or Death Don't Take Your Soul, whatever you want to call him. That's Kurt Angle, man, and I know it.
I'm not sure, man. I think that looks more like Hacksaw Jim Duggan under that mask, in my personal opinion. What the hell?
Okay.
Wait, but what is Alberto Patron doing out here?
Doing whatever he wants, but he's bombed out! Taking out that leg of Patriot Dome! Hacksaw Jim Duggan taking a beat! If that really is him under that mask, but I'm pretty sure it's not. I'm pretty sure it's Kurt Angle, like I said.
No, Kurt Angle retired weeks ago, and we know that it is not Kurt Angle. He's retired from professional wrestling. Seriously, though, right now, what the hell? Dos Caras Jr. right now with a steel chair now on Kurt Angle now. You gotta be kidding me.
That Patriot Dos Caras, you can't make up your mind, can you?
Hey, the point is, we know that's Alberto El Patron. We know that's who's attacking the Olympic gold medalist right now. Using a steel chair right now. This isn't a match. Jack Swagger's supposed to be doing battle right now with Patriot Dos right now. And Alberto El Patron just ruined that.
Oh, come on, you can say he ruined it. Oh, look at this. Look at this. El Patron, you're about to take that mask off, player. El Patron is about to take off that mask, player. Alberto just slammed his head against the stage, player.
El Patron right now attacking Kurt. Attacking Kurt Angle right now, taking off the mask. Okay, yeah, it is Kurt Angle. And that's Alberto Del Rio under the other mask.
We don't know that, player. We've never seen Dos Caras Jr. in masks. But we've seen Kurt Angle in masks here tonight, even before New Blood Rising. You know what? Now after we've seen this, man, the mask is off. Call the match off. There's no reason to have a mask versus mask match when Kurt Angle's already been unmasked and revealed here tonight on WCW Monday Nitro.
This is wrong. This is wrong right now. He's supposed to have a match against Jack Swagger. What is this all about? You know Jack Swagger, he hasn't been wrestling on TV for about a year now. He deserves more than that. He should be competing right now on television. He gets his chance, and then Alberto El Patron wants to ruin it.
Hey, man, he's doing Jack Swagger a favor, right? We all know Kurt Angle is going to go for the ankle and try to break his ankle and end his career. It's sad that Kurt Angle tried to do something like that, player. He tried to end Buddy Murphy's career we saw last week, but he didn't do it. Buddy Murphy's still walking around, still 100%, still all good, man. Luckily Kurt Angle let go of the ankle lock when he tapped out. Oh, come on, now he's going to try in. He's going to try in my dude's Dos Caras Jr.'s career with that steel chair, but it ain't going to happen.
This isn't a match right now. This is not a match. This is not an official match right now. This is why the referee is trying to stop this, but he can't do anything about it. And look at these uppercuts from Kurt Angle. European uppercuts from Kurt Angle on Dos Caras Jr. Just taking them apart right now. This is incredible. A drop kick by Kurt Angle.
Man, I hope Dos Caras Jr. breaks his freaking neck. That's what he needs to do right now. For all we know, Kurt Angle's neck probably already broke. Probably never got fixed. Look how many times he had neck problems. Now look at this, he's trying to end my dude's career right now, player.
Kurt Angle's a machine. He lets that aggressive side get too much of him. He could very well end Dos Caras Jr.'s career, but he's not going to do it. Luckily, Dos Caras Jr. was able to escape, but Kurt Angle is going to lock in the ankle lock. The ankle lock locked in on Dos Caras Jr. right before WCW New Blood Rising, sending a message here, forcing him to tap out. And this isn't even a match.
It's a bunch of bullcrap is what it is, man. It's sad that Kurt Angle would come out here and assault Dos Caras Jr. like this when Dos Caras Jr. isn't even booked for the show tonight. He's not even supposed to be here. He should be at home with his wife, Sarah Knight. His future wife to be, Sarah Knight, man. Instead of being here, instead Kurt Angle, he dragged him out here. He insulted his family. And he probably kicked his dog or something to get him here in the arena so he can assault him. It's sad. He set those Carter Jr. up, I'm telling you.
Well, we know it's Kurt Angle that's taking on Alberto El Patron, or we don't know if it's Alberto El Patron. Dos Carter Jr., I should say. But we're going to see the Patriots Dos versus Dos Carter Jr. at WCW New Blood Rising. But there's more matches to come. Here tonight, up next, Shinsuke Nakamura, Samoa Joe versus Carl Anderson, and Luke Gallows. Don't go anywhere. At WCW New Blood Rising, we will see Okada versus EC3 versus Billy Gunn versus the WCW champion, Samoa Joe, who is still undefeated. We will also see Alexa Bliss versus Dana Brooke in a match that Dana Brooke calls the Bare Body Beatdown match, where they'll be wrestling in their swimming gear. We will also see Kevin Nash, Big Sexy, do battle with the Lord of Darkness, the Phenom, The Undertaker. I can't speak right now.
You can't. You can't speak at all, to be honest. Let me take over this one, right? The Icon Sting is back. We saw earlier tonight, we saw Dolph Ziggler defeat that imposter that Sting sent out there.
Wait, what?
No.
What?
He sent that imposter out there to distract Dolph Ziggler so he can attack him with that baseball bat. Okay. But it's all good. Dolph Ziggler's getting his revenge at New Blood Rising. Speaking of revenge, Goldberg's gonna try to get some revenge, but he's gonna be embarrassed. He's 2-2 so far here in WCW. He's got 2 wins, but he's got 2 losses at the hands of the big giant Big Show and Roman Reigns.
Remember, Goldberg has foot on the ropes tonight. The referee never saw it.
And now, we also gotta see Kurt Angle, because we know it's Kurt Angle, versus one of the greatest men in Mexico history, Dos Carter Jr. Mask versus mask match. They need to call that off, because there's no point in it. We already seen Kurt Angle and mask. What's the point?
The match is still gonna go ahead. Kurt Angle will put that mask back on for the mask versus mask match. We will also see the WCW Women's Championship on the line. Asuka versus Nia Jax. And we will also see a match that was just added tonight, ladies and gentlemen, at New Blood Rising. The NWO versus Randy Orton, John Cena, and Shinsuke Nakamura. What's going to happen when the Baldies go up against some of the greatest franchises in WWE and New Japan Pro Wrestling history?
Oh, Claire, my dude Nathan Jones is lacing up them boots, Claire. He's going to be teaming up with Buddy Murphy to take on Devon and Bubba, the Dudley Boys.
Comes Big Luke Gallows making his way to the ring right now. We saw how dominant he could be in Aces and Eights. We saw how dominant he was with the Straight Edge Society as well. And now we've seen how devastating he could be with the Bullet Club, but now he's with the NWO. And Luke Gallows is showing no signs of slowing down. He looks to be even more dominant than ever before, just like he was at all times.
What? Man, just be quiet. Let me introduce my dude Carl Anderson right now, alright, player? You over here must be distracted with something. I'm just saying. Here we go with the new franchise of WCW. My dude Carl Anderson, the greatest talent in the NWO today. But then again, when I say that, I think about every other member of the NWO, man. So it's real close, because once you're with the NWO, man, I mean, it's automatic.
You're not making any sense right now.
Come on, man.
You're really not making, let me take off. Listen, Carl Anderson, Machine Gun, Carl Anderson, MGK in the ring right now. He is a big threat to Samoa Joe's streak, as well as Luke Gallows at night. And also with Shinsuke Nakamura, him teaming up with Samoa Joe. He can take the loss, and that will count against Samoa Joe's record. So Samoa Joe has to have a lot of trust in Shinsuke Nakamura here tonight. And these two, they haven't really liked each other in the past. They've done battles with each other in the past. Now they're teaming up here tonight on Nitro in the main event. Both champions, WCW World Champion Samoa Joe and United States Heavyweight Champion Shinsuke Nakamura. Should be very interesting to see what happens when these two team up. Wait a minute. Who's that coming out here with Samoa Joe? That's The Undertaker. The Undertaker coming out here supporting Samoa Joe. Like I said earlier, the NWO had to have something to do with that imposter Kane attacking The Undertaker earlier tonight. We already saw them come out with the imposter Sting, and the real Sting would show up. But I can tell you now, the real Kane won't be showing up here in WCW. He's signed, he's contracted for SmackDown. So who is this imposter dressed up as Kane that's trying to help the NWO here?
Man, what about here with that? Whatever, dude. Right now, man, I don't think Samoa Joe should be focused on Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson. This is the man he needs to be focused on. This is the man that could cost him his streak. Shinsuke Nakamura, the king of strong style, the king of swag, right? He could cost him this match, I'm telling you.
What a battle we saw between Shinsuke Nakamura, the United States Heavyweight Champion, and John Cena on WCW Thunder about a month ago now. The greatest match in WCW Thunder history. Shinsuke Nakamura making his way to the ring. He could definitely be a future World Heavyweight Champion in WCW. But he doesn't have his chance coming up just yet. A man that is getting an opportunity at that title at the WCW World Championship is Okada. A man that was just tag team champions with Nakamura. I bring it up all the time, of course, John Cena and Randy Orton. That's the team that they defeated. They defeated Shinsuke Nakamura and Okada to become the tag team champions. But Shinsuke Nakamura would get his revenge when he beat John Cena for the United States Heavyweight Championship. But right now, this is all about Samoa Joe's strength. Can Nakamura be trusted? Will we see Samoa Joe defeated for the first time at the hands of Shinsuke Nakamura?
Hey man, I think the streak is coming to an end. I'm telling you, man. This is the main event on Nitro. He's got a Fatal 4-Way match coming up. He needs to focus on that. And the streak could come to an end at New Blood Rising if he's not gonna win here tonight, man. So Samoa Joe has a lot on his plate. If I know Samoa Joe like I know him, he gonna try to eat all of
it. You seriously just tell a fat joke right now?
I'm telling you, man.
There's the bell. Here we go.
He's fat!
Here we go. Samoa Joe, Luke Gallows starting things off. The big man in the group. The big man in this match. Luke Gallows with the rights and lefts. Kevin Nash coming out here. Ringside with Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson, The Undertaker on the side of Samoa Joe and Nakamura. Nice move there by Luke Gallows. He tried to go for a roundhouse kick, it looked like. Tried to kick Samoa Joe's head in, and it did not work. Look at Samoa Joe go here. Slapping him across the chest with a chop. Slapping him across the face. Another slap across the face, this time by Luke Gallows. Two slaps to the face. Went for a third. Samoa Joe blocks it. But Samoa Joe gets cornered. But he gets an elbow in right across the nose of Luke Gallows. And right now, Luke, he's trying to put in some work right now, but it's not happening. It's not happening. Samoa Joe isn't going to let it happen, it seems. Look at this. Look at Samoa Joe go! We'll go for the cover. Here we go. One. Only going to be a one count. Wow. Kick to the back, but look at this. Luke Gallows. powers out of it. He just absorbed that kick like it was nothing right now. Samoa Joe's not absorbing these punches from Luke Gallows. So look at this. Look at this. Now Luke Gallows. Oh, got every punch in right there on Samoa Joe. And now he puts his foot in his chest. But Samoa Joe throws it away.
And Samoa Joe almost broke his arm just trying to keep that foot from connecting with him. Look at up. Why are you going to hit Kindness? What was Luke? What Kindness having in the match? Come on, Samoa Joe. That should be a disqualification. Hitting a man that's not even involved in this match, man. Come on.
Samoa Joe on the top, on the middle rope. Look at Luke Gallows there. Moves out of the way and then falls up with a drop kick real quick across the back of Joe. But Joe gets out of the ring, but Luke Gallows is going to try to stay on him. And that's not going to work. Right to the steel stairs.
That's all good. Luke Gallows still standing.
Oh, Samoa Joe diving out of the ring with a suicide dive.
You ain't gonna let him get in the ring? Well, it's all good because Carl Anderson's about to get in the ring now. Come on, Clark. There you go. Elbow right to the back of the head. Kevin Nash gonna check on Big Luke, make sure he all right. Clothesline to the face. Got him. And now Luke Gallows is back in. Watch out where you kicking, Luke. Carl. Here we go now, man. Big Luke. My dude. Boom. Got a corner. Back. Oh. Flapjack. Samoa Joe, man. He loves flapjacks. Trust me.
I hope Samoa Joe looks back at this and hears what you're saying about him. And now Carl Anderson with another clothesline across the face of Samoa Joe. Kevin Nash is dangerous for Samoa Joe out here because remember, when Samoa Joe was the World Heavyweight Champion with Impact Wrestling, when he went up against Sting at Bound for Glory, he had the upper hand, it seems. Kevin Nash came out with Sting's back. Smacked him across the back with it. We didn't know what was going on, but later on we would find out the main event mafia would form.
Samoa Joe would actually later join the main event mafia years later to try to take down Immortal. And Kevin Nash actually left Impact Wrestling because he saw what was happening. He saw Immortal starting to be formed. He decided he was going to have no part of that. He left Impact Wrestling. He saw what was happening in Impact Wrestling and decided to leave. What's Luke Gallows going to do here? Luke Gallows smacking Samoa Joe off the middle rope here. The referee needs to step in and do something about it. Or maybe Samoa Joe's going to do something about it first. Knocks Luke Gallows. Oh, no. We saw this earlier. This is how Mark Henry lost. 1, 2. The streak still continues. Samoa Joe was able to get the shoulder up at the last second. And now look at this. Shinsuke Nakamura getting involved. The knee across the back by Samoa Joe.
I don't want to start anything, but Nakamura had a lot of time to break that pinfall out. He did not try to break it up, though. Look at this. Here we go again, man. All right, he got out that time, but Nakamura had a lot of time to break up that first one, and he didn't. Now, why is that? I'm just saying. Uh-oh. Kick out the back of Carl Anderson. Oh, play. Ooh. Got a jump
the
right
rocket
there.
Kick.
Magic kick.
The rocket kick by Carl Anderson right now. And Nakamura comes in. Carl Anderson probably could have ended the streak right there. Thankfully, Samoa Joe Nakamura came in. He was able to stop all that. Oh, a knee to the back of Nakamura.
Luke Gallows going to try to get Nakamura here. There's just a lot of chaos going on right now. We got a chair thrown in the ring by Kevin Nash. We got Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows getting involved here. The legal man is Carl Anderson and Samoa Joe. Nakamura getting out of the ring as he should since he's not the legal man. And now Carl Anderson. Samoa Joe has Cole. European uppercut. Just taking him out here. Luke Gallows has no choice but to get out. The referee was counting him out. Could result in a disqualification if he's counted out. As the referee tries to get the chair out of the ring, Luke Gallows comes back in. You gotta be kidding me. Look at this. Luke Gallows not even in this match. He can't even hit Samoa Joe right now. Here we go. Tag made by Samoa Joe on Shinsuke Nakamura. Shinsuke Nakamura now the legal man. But Carl Anderson's the one that's legal. Look at this small package by Nakamura on Carl Anderson.
Two. Come on, man. Kick out.
No. Kick out by Carl Anderson.
That's what I'm talking about. Ugh. They didn't do much. Bam. There we go. Double team by Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson, man. My dude Luke Gallows and Luke Gallows ring though, for real right now. Oh, come on. There we go. Take him apart. Might as well. Watch out. There we go. He getting out of the ring. It's all good. And watch this. Look at this. Boom! Electric chair drop. Dropping Nakamura face first. That's going to be all the fat lady wrote. Or the fat
Samoa
dude
Joe
wrote.
Streak.
Samoa Joe the streak.
No.
Oh, crap.
It's not going to be it. Only a two count. Drop kick attempt from Carl Anderson. Oh! I think Nakamura just went for the Kinshasa. Oh, a knee to the head of Carl Anderson. He just kicks him down. Bam! A kick across the face. A field goal kick from Nakamura. Hit him where the sun shines bright. The back of that head of Carl Anderson. A drop kick. Still going. Still going. Not stopping. Nakamura. Oh!
He's gonna work. I can admit that. Uh-oh. And then Carl Anderson's gonna be.
Look at this. What is this? Oh! Right. Nakamura toss of Carl Anderson. Come on, Kyle. You're gonna be looking at the Kinshasa right now. Look at Luke Gallows! Come on!
Yeah! Luke Gallows just running over Nakamura like a big old monster truck. Hell yeah. Gallows put in that work. Boom. And now Carl Anderson about to pick up the scraps.
Samoa Joe asking for a tag here. Nakamura loses this match. His streak comes to an end. Hopefully it doesn't. Hopefully it can keep going. Luke Gallows gets the tag, and now Luke Gallows on the ropes. Big boot to the face of Nakamura. And now Carl Anderson. Now he's out of there. And what a show here tonight we've had on WCW Nitro, ladies and gentlemen. Right now we're getting some late breaking news about New Blood Rising. Ladies and gentlemen, as we know, New Blood Rising is going to be in Texas. Ric Flair just got Austin Aries reinstated. I don't know why. We got late breaking news coming in right now. I'm trying to see if I hear this right. Oh, we're going for a chokeslam here. Wait a minute. Nakamura knocking down. Oh! I don't know if he got all that knee right there when he went for Luke Gallows. And Carl Anderson's going to make sure he breaks it up anyways. He knocks down Carl Anderson. He knocks down Luke Gallows. Oh, man. This might be it right here. Kinshasa! Is it all over here? One, two, three, it's all.
Oh my God, Kevin Von Erich. Kevin Von Erich is going to be a Nuclear Rising. I don't know why, but Kevin Von Erich will be in Texas at WCW New Blood Rising, ladies and gentlemen. You got to get your tickets now. They may be sold out already, but Kevin Von Erich is supposed to be at WCW New Blood Rising. It involves Austin Aries and Ric Flair. I don't know what's happening, but it will happen at WCW New Blood Rising. Shinsuke Nakamura just got the win for Samoa Joe. His undefeated streak is still going strong.
You gotta be kidding me. You know what? That's exactly what happened in the past with WCW. They had too many legends, too many part-timers, too many old guys going around here. And now we got Goldberg going around here. We got Undertaker, Sting. I mean, come on, man. We need to fire these guys and just let the NWO, the young stars, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson and Kevin Nash, take over right now, player. I'm just saying.
We'll see Goldberg versus Roman Reigns. We'll see Samoa Joe versus Okada versus EC3 versus Billy Gunn for the World Heavyweight Championship. We will see Kevin Von Erich at WCW New Blood Rising. Austin Aries' suspension has been lifted. Ric Flair is set to appear. What the hell is going to happen at WCW New Blood Rising? And look at this. It seems Samoa Joe and Shinsuke Nakamura can get along. But will Samoa Joe still be undefeated at WCW New Blood Rising? He's got three different opponents. Good night, everybody. We'll see you Sunday in WCW New Blood Rising.